Ryan's by his side.
Sit.
For the select few, this process might make them. But for the majority of these celebrities...
God!
It will completely break them.
Hands. Walk.
Move! Come on! Let's go!
In this series...
We can do it!
16 celebrity recruits...
Go! Second!
...will leave their glamorous lives behind.
Get out of here! Get it!
They will be put through the most grueling stages of SAS selection by an elite team of ex-Special Forces soldiers.
Honesty, integrity, trust.
Everything we've installed in you from day one. Everything!
No allowances or exceptions will be made.
Tell your stomach!
I'm not scared of getting dirty, but I'm going to have to change these. I can just about open my car door.
Go! Whoa, 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 whoa!
My mum does not want me to do this. She's scared I'm going to get injured. I think she's really, really not looking forward to that.
I've seen pressure.
I need support! Now!
So what I'm going to face on this course is water off a duck's back.
Take it down!
Like an injured slug.
Let off your boat!
No other test asks as much.
You got it! Let's go!
Well done, Soso.
Or means as much.
Well done.
To the few who make it through.
Welcome to your worst nightmare.
Oh my God, the sun.
Of the 16 celebrity recruits who began...
The sun is out.
Just 12 remain.
Give me that sun, please. I'm soaked.
It's going to be sunny today. So for those of us who need it, suntan lotion, I will definitely need it. Oh. Today's going to be a hard day.
Feels so nice.
You won't be saying that after about 10 minutes of walking, in it?
Get on parade!
Let's do it.
Let's go, let's go.
After 4 days of rain, the weather has taken a turn, with the temperature already over 40 degrees.
It is hot.
This heat is brutal.
I don't care whether you want water, everybody down water, OK?
Yes, sir.
When you're working alongside comrades on the battlefield, it is absolutely paramount. You trust that person with your life. We're all on the same page. We've all got the same focus. That's what we're trying to put into your head. Honesty, integrity, trust, belief, it all wraps into one. What I'm going to do now is put you into two teams. Team Alpha, number 9, team leader. Put your hand up. That's the one you got. Good lad. Come to the front. Number 5, number 2, 8, 6 and 1. You're in Team Alpha. Team Bravo team leader is 14. 3, 13, 10, 7, 11. Look around. That's your team. Go! Stay in formation, let's go!
In the Special Forces, we are just a group of individuals that can work together very well as a team.
Get here!
It is so important to understand everyone's strengths and weaknesses. You have to work together as a strong unit, because ultimately, when you're on a mission and chaos is reigning all around, you have to be able to trust your teammates to get a job done.
Well, I want 2 ranks in front of me, not files. You're in files, I want ranks.
Because if you don't, people will end up dying.
This task is all about resupply. It's about moving equipment over difficult terrain to a point that requires it. We have all been involved in these sort of operations. You've got to dig deep, because it's hard work. You have got a minute to chat through what your preferred method of moving this shit is. Go!
Well, I'm heavy.
In one of the most physically demanding tasks yet, Both teams will go head-to-head in a race to move 200 kilograms of equipment over 6 kilometers.
That'd be two man.
Team Alpha is led by number 9, ex-RAF technician and Paralympian, John Allen Butterworth.
That's full of sand.
Full of sand. That'd be two people. Back when I was in the RAF, I definitely kind of learned some leadership skills. I think if people are generally struggling, I'll be the first one to help anybody. Can the box be opened?
Yes.
Possibly. Can you put things, something in it? You know, I'll be the one to volunteer to kind of carry the most weight or do what I can to help best for the kind of good of the team.
Right, let's move, let's go.
Move. Come on, hurry up. Roll the tigers. Roll them.
Speed is of the essence.
We come back for the boxes. Yeah. We move forward, come back for the
boxes. Can you run in that?
Yeah.
Go and run.
Team Bravo is led by number 14, singer Siva Kanaswaran.
I'm not a great problem solver, which is not great for this.
Leave him here for now and go back and get the rest of the stuff.
Okay.
Yes.
Go.
I live a very peaceful life. I chill out at home. I got my missus and my two little cute dogs, and it's a very comfortable life.
Go, go.
So I don't create problems to solve them.
Teddy, get ahead. Get ahead, Teddy. Let's not have too much separation within your teams.
Which way?
On me, on me, on me.
Come on, move. Let's go. Move yourself.
In an attempt to get ahead, number 14, Siva.
Come on now, really, really dig deep.
Has left teammates number 7, Gareth Gates, and number 13, Zoe Lyons, behind.
Hurry up!
Team Bravo, we need help at the back.
Bravo! Fuck's sake!
You're pulling ahead, Alpha!
I set the next waypoint.
Under number 9, John Allen's leadership, Team Alpha move into the lead.
Good effort.
Keep pushing up.
Come on, Alpha!
Right, push forward. I think I can be as good as most people in a lot of things and a lot of time better.
Keep going.
I do feel like every challenge can be solved. Things like IKEA, and it always says two people, four hands, and I managed to do one hand, and it's just because it's use your head, use anything you can that you've got.
Good, good work.
Let's go.
Ready to go again? Let's do this. Come on, come on. This is it.
When you're carrying heavy equipment to the front line, it is brutal. You can feel the sun beating down on you, and you can feel the energy being sapped from your body.
This ain't supermarket sweep. Let's go.
You've got to keep pushing on, no matter how exhausted you are, because ultimately, everyone's lives are in your hands.
Get in there, Alpha.
You need to be able to trust your leader to keep that team moving, as they have to trust you to get the job done.
Bravo, you're miles behind. Start commanding this team, number 14. You've got no system in place, and you're just like a bag of shit.
One, two, three, go.
Here we go. Come on now. Take it easy. Take it easy.
Despite number 7, Gareth, and number 13, Zoe, catching up.
Let's work a system and let's close these gaps.
Team Bravo are still behind.
Get a grip of this team. You're in charge. Teddy! You do not want to be the last team.
Are you ready? Come on, three, two,
one,
go.
One,
hold
on. Two, three. Deep breath, Siva, deep breath. Let's go.
We have to catch that box. It's got to be like a conveyor belt.
Love Island was, you know, a romantic holiday. It's completely different to what I'm going to be putting myself through in this course. The whole reason why I'm doing this is to finally put to rest the need for validation. I really do need a reset. I really need to kind of find myself again.
One in a heavy one, Steve, but do not touch that light can. 3, 2, 1, go!
Let's go, Siva! You've got it in you! Hurry up!
Come on, Alpha, we're gonna win this. Let's not lose it now.
Jermaine, head up.
That's it, 5.
Being a footballer, you know, you get put through intense training, but this, it's on a different scale. I have no idea what I'm letting myself in for. And that's scary.
Come on, team!
On me!
Number 9, John Allen, leads Team Alpha to the drop zone first.
Top of the tyres, on top of the tyres.
Get some water. Water.
Water now.
Get water inside them.
Let your lungs heave in and out.
Good effort. Good effort.
Warm us up the hill.
Block out the pain and let's get it up there.
Right to the top, mate. Very top, come on.
2 minutes later, Team Bravo arrive.
Stand up, get some water on.
After 1 hour, with temperatures reaching 42 degrees, the recruits think the task is over.
Be prepared to go again.
Right, to the next DS as quick as you can, go! Let's move!
In the second phase of the task...
Get your kit in the boat and get across to the left-hand bank.
The recruits must now race across a lake.
Bergen's in the middle.
Bergen's in the back of the middle.
Let's go.
Okay, two on each side.
That's fine.
Here we go, come on, off, 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 come on. That's it, get nice and quick.
I thought I did pretty well in Pop Idol, made the final, but stumbled on the last hurdle, unfortunately.
I'll go.
I found that hard, and so my main drive for this is to prove to the British public that I am a winner.
Right, come on!
Winning again? Go.
This is not Weekend at Bernie's! Push left!
One, two...
Team Alpha are the first to arrive at the bank.
Get the boat and everything out of the water. Follow me!
One, two, three, go. Come on, that's it.
Team Bravo follow closely behind.
Right, we're not going to get it through these trees. On the side.
Both teams must now carry their 80-kilogram boat half a kilometre to the finish line.
Come on!
One, two. We can get past them now.
Team Alpha, led by recruit number 9, John Allen, battle their way to the front.
You get a win, go!
That's it, world class.
Are you happy with where you are?
Guys, stop.
Get it. Guys, this isn't working. What the fuck are we doing?
Swap with me, Siva. Swap with me, get at the back. Right, come on, guys, Siva, hurry up.
Can you not do the front?
No, because he's struggling at the front. Three,
you not, and I
two,
here.
One, okay, up we go. Pass it, march forward.
With number 14, Siva, struggling, number 7, Gareth, takes over as leader.
March forward, one, two.
It takes a lot for me to lose my temper. However, sometimes that helps my speech impediment.
One, two, come on now.
If I'm really pushed to my limits, I seem to then be able to speak fluently through shouting at people.
One, two.
Hopefully they'll push me to my limits.
Let's go! Strike! Strike!
Team Alpha...
Put it down.
...are the first to reach the finish line, winning the task.
Stand up and proud.
Look what we've fucking done.
All the way in, do not drop that boat again.
Team Bravo finish 3 minutes behind.
Take some breaths, get focused.
Bergen's on, 2 ranks in front of me.
This day is long, long from over.
Let's go.
Team Alpha on me.
Team Bravo, follow on.
Pain is temporary, pride is forever. Stay tight, too. Get up the accommodations.
Come on, then, let's catch it up. Get up there.
Having pushed themselves to their limits...
That was tough.
...the 12 remaining recruits must now recover.
That was a beasting.
Oh, honestly, that's the hardest thing I've ever done in my life.
Jermaine, are you okay?
I'm just fucked, bro.
Guys, I need a bit of help.
Are you overheating? I think you need some water over your head.
Get a medic now. What hurts on you?
Everything, my arm. Can't pick it up. The lady can't pick it up. I'm fucking hot.
Deep breaths. In through your nose, out through your mouth.
The medic has been called for number 9, John Allen.
Just don't move.
Hey, where's number 9?
Number 9's here.
I'd like you guys to move away. Right. Number 9? Feeling dizzy, lightheaded? Can you pass out at all, number 9?
No. Okay. Stay with it.
What we're going to do, we're going to cool you down, OK?
Yeah.
Let's get him some sugar. His eyes are going.
You need a doctor, mate.
I feel like we need a medic.
A medic!
Also suffering is number 5, Jermaine.
I want you on the floor, OK?
Good, I've got you. Now lie yourself down.
Breathe out.
Doctor, we've got a problem down here as well.
And number 14, Siva.
Come down, we've got a problem.
Oh, that's so hard.
Slowly, nice and slowly. We've got 3 of come down with severe heat injury.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, over you. Just cool you down.
That was a wipe out that round, wasn't it?
That was harsh.
So, 5, 9 and 14. They're going to have to go to the hospital, get their bloods checked.
Lost 3 of our fucking strongest people.
Listen, that is part of the game, isn't it? We all got beasted, everyone got beasted, but if you end up ill, then you can't carry on if you're ill, can you?
Following the ammo resupply task, number 5, Jermaine, number 9, John Allen, and number 14, Siva, have been medically withdrawn from the course.
Oh, I can't believe
number
it.
Number 9, yeah, God.
This time, step up now, Ted.
Hey, you do your thing.
This is the time to step up.
This is it, man. This is where it turns on its head.
I feel like my feet have been broken. I feel like the tops of my feet are smashed with a baseball bat.
Right, so this morning was the ammo resupply and bolt carry.
With 9 recruits now remaining, the DS meet to discuss today's task.
To be honest, that was abysmal.
Yeah.
Fucking morning of PT. Everything's gone to shit, innit?
Obviously, we came back to camp, and then we had number 5, number 9, and number 14 all medical withdrew from the course. Over to you, Foxy.
Yeah, briefing teams up. Left up the fucking way they were going to do it, the tactics behind how they were going to move the kit completely up to them. And then they cracked on, quite frankly, from the get-go. Team Alpha were leaps and bounds ahead of Team Bravo. I was going to say under the command of 14, but let's say under the lack of command from 14, it fell to an absolute shower of shite.
Number 7, he took control of the situation and he did get a grip of them as they approached the hill near the temple and they closed the gap, but they were miles behind from the other team, to be honest.
Number 7. His name's popping up on every one of our radars now.
He's really coming
all
on
for the right things.
That's right. He really is.
He's all ears. He wants to learn.
Yeah, I think he's here for the right reasons.
Worth a chat tonight, you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Should we bring him in?
I am losing my mind in this accommodation. I feel like we're all going delirious.
We're all going a bit.
We're all losing our fucking marbles.
Recruit number 7!
What? Number 7?
Number 7.
Jesus, what's happening?
Shh. Right over here, 7. Hands by your side. Sit.
How are you feeling?
I mean, I'm battered and bruised everywhere. My feet are really, really sore, but it's all part of it, I guess.
Is it as tough as you thought?
Oh, it's much, much harder.
You've been quite quiet, almost a grey man, but I've seen a change, and then watching you confidently go about your business, it was impressive to see.
Just tell us a little bit about yourself. I don't know a lot about you.
I'm from Bradford in Yorkshire.
I know Bradford.
For me, growing up was hard.
What family life you mean?
No, not school. You know, having a stammer. School was hard. Come on. Just, verbally abused, physically. Come on.
During school days?
Yeah, just, lads kind of, oh, man, I said I wouldn't do this. Lads just holding me down and just, you know, kind of shouting out things, you know, let's beat the words out of it. And I think that's why I'm here, to kind of show myself this time that I am stronger and that I'm not, hopefully this time I won't break. I think that's why I'm here.
But, you know, from what you're saying there, you know, it's made you who you are today.
Yeah.
How did you pick yourself up to then put yourself forward for the TV show?
Mum actually forced me to do it. You know, she kind of saw that I had a voice and was like, look, son, you know, you need to, you know, from somewhere find the courage, you know, to kind of force yourself into that situation. And
thank God for your mother pushing you into that.
Yeah, I'm thankful that she did that because, you know, there's lots of other people that I know that have the same issue as me but don't find their outlet. And I think, you know, it's the same with the gym now. You know, I go to the gym because the frustration that I live with every day, you know, from not being able to get my words out, you know, I'm able to then kind of thrash it out in the gym, and that kind of keeps my mindset.
Gives you focus.
Yeah, yeah, in the right place.
You're capable, that's the truth. Don't fucking have any doubt in your mind.
No.
If I'm honest, you're quite close to front running. So you've got potential, you've got a good fucking chance.
Yep.
So hang in there. The longer you're here, the better you'll feel and get out of this.
Sure.
We're just going to turn up the heat.
The last thing I want to do is kind of give up.
God!
Stan.
I didn't realize so bad.
I must be so frustrated.
Jesus Christ. The bullying at school, you know, became just unbearably bad.
That was short and sweet.
Yeah, just a little chat about how I'm finding things and that's it. Oh, God. I've got those, you know, kind of horrendous scars there still. I think if I can get through this course, it would just prove to myself that I am strong. And I really, really want to feel I've grown and I've learned and I can handle anything.
No, I don't prefer Will Young. I love Gareth as well, but I'm a big Will Young fan.
But you don't need to compare the two.
There's no comparison. Gareth's better.
Chalk and cheese.
I second that. I can't even think about... Bleh. Can't even talk.
Worse than me.
You got that out quickly.
Having tested the recruits as a team, for the next part of the trust phase, the DS want to focus on them individually.
The brief was all about trust, so let's just do a basic sort of integrity test.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And obviously the emphasis has been on them giving 100%. Trust, integrity, honesty, all the ethos that we abide by.
That's a good shout.
Yeah.
I do actually miss home now. I wasn't really thinking about it at the start.
I definitely have a glass of champagne now, I want.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow. Amazing.
A nice cheese butty with ransom pickle.
Cheese butty.
Everybody on parade, clean for tea. Fucking run!
So what we're going to do next is a physical assessment. So it's a combat physical assessment. It's timed so we can gauge where you're all at in relation to each other. Is everyone understood so far?
Yes,
sir. Right, dress back into your comm until you're called forward.
Go.
The timed circuit is composed of six exercises in six different locations.
Number six! Stand by. Go!
The recruits must complete 20 reps at each station.
Crunch is next.
Let's go! Big effort. Fucking move on.
Two of the positions are out of vision of the DS. But what the recruits don't know is that they are being secretly filmed to test their trustworthiness.
Trust is paramount for Special Forces mission success. Whatever we are suffering through, what makes us strong is that we suffer together. We cut corners. That destroys the ethos of everything that we stand for.
Well, smash it out of the park.
Without that honesty and integrity, without that trust, there's nothing.
Go!
Next up is number one, Matt Hancock.
The thing about politics is you are criticised in public a lot.
Come on, number one, smash it out!
I've had my integrity attacked on grounds that are totally unreasonable, probably more than is fair.
Get your backside down, get your big fat ass down!
So if I'm not trusted, I find that frustrating, because I'm always trying to do my best.
All the way in, number one! All the way in! 17, 18, 19. Right, stand by, number three.
Next to take on the circuit is number three, Teddy Suarez.
Go!
I've kind of grown up with the need to constantly question my self-worth.
Next station, squats.
Goes hand in hand with the expectation to win. If I lost, like, at district sports, I was upset. I was devastated.
Everything you got.
The competitive nature in me kind of allows me to understand, all right, I'm a little bit of a sore loser. I don't like losing.
On the win! Big push. Round number three.
It's a good effort. I find it hard to believe she did.
That was mortal.
Thing. I'm surprised there was no one there watching us do each one.
Right, listen in, course. You've got 3 minutes to get some water down, yeah? We'll go again. You've got to beat the time you did the first time.
Oh, God.
Dig deep, everyone. Dig fucking deep.
Stand by. Go!
already fatigued by the first round.
Max effort, 7.
Smash it out.
The recruits must complete the circuit again.
My biggest inspiration in life is my mum. She's a very, very strong woman, very honest person.
Everything you got.
Work ethic is, I think, why I work so hard now and, you know, always wanting to achieve more and be more.
Go on, 7. All the way in.
5. Good effort.
Come on. Get it. 20 reps.
I'm healthy, I'm fit, I go to the gym, I play sports, but I'm not used to pushing myself to my absolute limit. I never do it.
Let's go, 8.
I like to just stay within my remit and what I feel comfortable doing. And I also like doing things that I know that I'm good at. And I won't do things that I know that I'm not good at because I don't like failing.
Finish strong. Come on, number 6.
On this course, as an athlete, my type of training that I've done in the past will help me. I've trained through pain. I feel like I've done the hardest event. I'm kind of a get on with it, let's get stuck in kind of girl.
Well done.
Well done, everyone.
I didn't think I'd be able to do that. I bashed my leg. Bashed myself again.
Those burpees. Fucking hell.
Let's have a look. 1, 2.
Following the task, the DS review the hidden footage.
6, 7.
To check the recruits have completed every repetition.
10.
10.5. And you know what's interesting?
Yeah.
He was a standout on the reps where he could be seen.
That's not a tired miscount, right?
No.
Let's have a look what else we got. Oh my God, who's this? I'll count. 1, 2-ish. 9, 10, 11.
She's even counting
on him. Did you hear that? So less than half and a complete verbal bluff.
That's fucking bad.
They're gonna get dragged in now, fucking exposed to this.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Imagine if you'd been asked to do that on, like, day 2.
No way.
You never would have got there. You would have been like, fuck this.
What a day.
Number 8, on the double. Foot on the gas, let's go.
Having reviewed the footage, the DS want to confront 2 recruits who cheated on the task.
Sit.
I'm going to show you something, and I want you to explain. Just explain how many reps you were asked to do on the circuit this morning.
20.
Count out loud how many physical exercises you count.
3.
Out loud.
4. 10. 11.
You think we're 2 idiots?
No, staff.
Can you be trusted?
Yes, staff.
Bullshit. Bullshit.
Yeah, I didn't do it to the best of my ability and I didn't listen to instructions with the amount that we were given.
Why?
Just my body was hurting.
So you're blatantly lying then? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, staff.
You fucking disappointed me, big star.
Sorry, staff.
What is the ethos way of smashing home here?
Believe in yourself and trust in your judgment and your instincts.
Absolutely.
I'm going to show you something. 8. 9.
You have just sat in front of me, regurgitated everything we fucking installed you from day one. Everything! Fucking dare you! Go on, explain it.
I just, I fucked up, I thought.
No shit, Sherlock.
I genuinely thought I did all the reps.
I sound like a fucking parrot, we all do. Trust. How fucking important that is in our world.
I am shit when I'm counting reps.
Bullshit.
I am.
Everyone on parade! Stand still. I told you right from the word go, we don't care where you came from, we don't care who follows you, we don't care who blows smoke up your ass. I asked 100%. Remember?
Yes, staff.
All the time. Number 3, stand out here, face. Number 8, stand out here and face. Explain to everybody why I've just had to regurgitate day one.
A point. I didn't finish the burpees, and I may have been short as well on the tuck jumps.
Tell them what you did. You cheated. You lied.
I miscounted with my breathing being crap.
Fuck off, number 3.
Stop. Just stop right there.
Own it.
Just own it.
That's what happened.
This is how we grow. Don't fucking argue with me. No. This is how you grow. In your words, number 8.
I let you guys down. I also fell short on the burpees and the tuck jumps.
We all make mistakes, but be accountable. Stop bullshitting.
That's why I stopped.
This is not our world. Shut up. You've said your fucking piece.
Number 3, number 8, follow me.
Go. Disappear.
As number 3, Teddy refuses to accept responsibility.
Number 3, dressing up to your neck. Number 8, same detail.
Both he and Montana will be punished.
Just walk in until it's up to your neck. Stand up.
When I say go, out the parade square, up to your room, go!
Didn't I say they were washing?
Of course they were.
There's no way you can cheat on that.
Yeah. Even if we weren't being filmed, we should have done it.
100%.
I wondered how Montana was getting around the course so quick. She was rapid.
And this is why they're talking about, like, trust, honesty, integrity.
Trust, that's right.
And they want to instill shame.
It's embarrassing. It's humiliating.
Teddy and number 8 Montana are being punished for cheating on the previous task.
All right, 8, 3, on me. Down here. We have a saying in recon, shame retains. So take this on board, learn from it, all right?
Thanks.
Come on over here.
Hi, guys.
Sorry, guys.
Sorry about that.
Absolutely sorry about that.
I thought you'd lost your head because you kept talking back.
I couldn't even back chat. I was just like, I've messed up there.
How short was you out of your dress?
Mine was 11.
Well, I got to 9.
Fuck
That's
off.
Fucking taking the piss, bruv. No.
The integrity signal.
Most people were competitive, they give it 100%.
But some of them,
basically just not putting in the effort.
Yeah. Both number 3 and number 8, they were fucking cheating.
Number 8,
She owned it, I'll give her that. She admitted to it. Number three went down the route of, I didn't know, I miscounted, he's bluffing us.
But he's still here by the skin of his teeth.
I think we need to find out where his head's at and what fucking purpose he's got of being here.
Yeah.
Happy? Good to go.
Right, let's roll it.
Number three!
Garden three.
Oh, shit.
Let's go, three!
Come in, sir.
Right over here, number three. Hands by your side. Sit.
How do you think it's all going, number three?
Tough, really tough.
I was quite shocked today, actually. We judge everybody on their 100%. You're not giving us 100%. And you know you're not. You right now should be fucking flying right at the front, and you ain't. Something else is bothering you. Anyway, tell me something about yourself. Go back to growing up, what was that all about? How was it?
So I'm originally a half-sibling. I'm a stepson to my mum, who I call my real mum, my blood mother. I don't know the true story. She gave me up. She just wasn't bothered with me, but I was always under the care of my dad and my stepmum. And she did amazing to not make me feel like an abandoned son. When I was 13, my dad passed away of cancer. My mum made it so that I didn't feel abandoned at all.
Take a breath, get yourself together.
Yeah, and I think I've always doubted myself where people have said, you're doing a good job. Why don't you believe in yourself? And I've never really had an answer. And then, yeah, I mean, I went on Love Island and I come out with a million followers, and then there's loads of people telling me that I'm a good guy and this, that, and the other. And bar one person, my real mum, didn't reach out. There's no, wow, son, I can see you. No phone call, no nothing. And initially I didn't care. I thought, why would I have any contact? Mm. She let me go years ago. I've never heard from her since. And over time, it's taken a toll on me because I've just thought, who am I? Is this everyone's just Teddy from Love Island? And I just feel lost.
I can see a lot of fucking trauma and emotion in your face. Do you think this uncertainty, or whatever you want to call it, comes from not having answers of growing up?
I think it's because... Yeah, there's the answers that my stepmom just can't answer.
Of course.
It's hard because if you asked me 2-3 years ago, do you need any contact from your own mum, I would have told you, no, I don't care. There's my answer, no. But I think I'm just sick of not knowing that part of who I am.
Yeah. Have you reached out to your mum?
No, I just haven't. I haven't really been brave enough. And I think it's literally the only thing that's stopping me is me.
It's all about having the courage and your own convictions. You learn that on this course. You're strong, you're capable. You just need to believe it yourself. That's what you're seeking now.
You've got to now fucking grab that bull by the horns and go, fuck this, here I go. Get every fucking second out of this. For you. Don't waste it.
Yes, sir.
God!
Head up. He needs to go and talk to his mother. That's what he wants to do, and he don't know how to do it because he's scared of upsetting his stepmother.
That'll be life-changing for him.
Yeah, I fucking hope so.
Son up, number three. We don't pull any punches, but you can take it.
Thank you, Stuff.
I've always fooled myself into thinking that I was okay with the fact that my real mum wasn't there or wanted to be there.
Mark just flings his shit everywhere and I'm like, I refuse to pick it up.
Try having four boys coming in with football boots that have been on AstroTurf.
Those black seeds, fuck me, my mum used to go skits at me for that.
Why wouldn't a mother of all people in a family not want to stick around? Why am I not good enough? That question, to me, was just not necessarily processed at all. I think this course needs to build up my mental toughness, my mental resilience. In the moments where I feel lost, I'm going to feel like there is a light at the end of the tunnel.
Next time...
It's not over! Keep going! On your belly! Stay low! Go on then, suck it up and let's move again!
When the chips are down and everything's going wrong...
Oh, wait.
Only the ones with grit and determination survive.